on the grid now, the four for the next heat. Frans Wurts, the leader in the championship, you get 20 points for a win. Martin Skanker, the Norwegian in second place, therefore could do with a win today to get himself back in front of Wurts. But Wurts with the works-built Audi Quattro, the turbocharged four-wheel drive car, an ideal rally car, an ideal rallycross car, and he's, there he is, in the B2000 Racing Audi Quattro on the inside. Next to him in the red Porsche from Finland, Matti Alamäki, currently fourth in the rallycross championship, and then alongside him the bright green Renault Alpine of the Belgian Luc Noyen, a tiny little car with lots of power in the boot, and then our own John Clark from Tadworth in Surrey with his 3-litre Porsche. So Quattro, Porsche, Alpine and Porsche, and we look now down for the lights, which are going to go red and then green to start this 3.5 lap heat. Wurts on the inside, Alamäki next to him, then the Alpine. The lights are red, now they're green. The field move away, and a wonderful start from Alamäki in the middle. It's Alamäki's red Porsche, which storms into the lead from Frans Wurts, the championship leader, and coming round the outside, John Clark pressing through with his Porsche alongside the Alpine, which is already losing some of its rear bodywork. But a wonderful start for Alamäki of Finland in the red Porsche, down to the elbow for the first time. Hanging the tail, this is tarmac. They've just come off chalk. They go up this hill to the hairpin on tarmac, and then they've got a very muddy corner waiting them at the bottom of this hill through the hairpin, with Frans Wurts closing in number one. He carries number one to denote he's the championship leader. He's closing on Alamäki about 100 miles an hour briefly on the brakes now, into the paddock bend, onto the rough. Bouncing through goes the Audi in second place of Frans Wurts. The Porsche getting briefly away. A big bounce from the Porsche now. They cross the start line. 2.5 laps left to go, and already Alamäki is down on the chalk of Chessen's Drift, and Frans Wurts getting a little bit closer briefly, but now falling back. Four-wheel drive, of course, for the Audi. Two-wheel drive and rear engine, and lots of 3.2 litres Porsche power in the red Porsche of Alamäki. And Alamäki scrubbing the chalk off as he hangs the tail out, a much neater line from the four-wheel drive Audi. Up the hill once again to the hairpin for the second time. The Porsche has pulled out a little bit, lifting the inside wheel. Round goes the Audi of Frans Wurts, and Wurts falling back now. A wonderful performance from Alamäki, the Finn, and there's a problem there. There's a fire. In fact, the champion leader is on fire. He doesn't know it. We can see it. Lots of, he must be able to see it in his mirror. The marshals are waving him off. A big fire from the turbocharged Audi. That's what we've seen so often with these turbocharged cars, the little Renault of Luc Noyen creeping by, and there now is the leader, Matti Alamäki, bouncing over the bumps as he comes now. In fact, John Clark has had to stop because we've got so much fire down there. The car is on the start, on the road, on the track there at Paddock Bend, and the car behind, the white and red Porsche creeping through, is John Clark. Meanwhile, the leader is well on his way. There he is, coming through the hairpin. The yellow flag denotes danger ahead of him as he comes down the hill, and we think we're going to run this race again, because clearly the two other challengers, Wurts out of the race very much, but the other two challengers for Matti Alamäki, who is still going very, very quickly. Now he gets the black flag. Now they're waving him down to a halt. So the Finn Alamäki is finally stopped in Porsche number four, and we're going to have a restart. You see in the red and white crash helmet a disconsolate Frans Wurts, and if the damage there is serious, that means that it's bad news for Frans Wurts, the championship leader. It's very good news for Martin Skanker, whom we'll be seeing later. Martin Skanker, who is currently second, and we're going to look at it again as they come down the hill. The Audi slipping back a little bit. It goes on the grass coming out. There you see the flames. The turbocharger is on that side of the car, under the bonnet, and it's burning away very merrily indeed. As Frans Wurts comes down the hill, he doesn't know it yet, because it's only now that the smoke starts in the back of the in the mirror, and rallycross drivers don't often look in their mirrors. It's hard enough to see through the windscreen in rallycross. The engine is burning merrily, and we are now getting news that in fact the results are going to stand of that race. race because they ran more than 75% of the distance. So Franz Wurz, therefore, there he is walking home, and that's really bad news for him because the current European Championship leader, unless they can sort that out very quickly in the paddock, and it looked pretty terminal damage to me, that's going to say goodbye to any more points for him today, and it's a full finish there for Matti Alamäki, and that's going to put him in a good position when he gets to the final later on.